Alright there, boxing fans. This is Ronell Higg, Boxing Reports. Alright, so, you know, I really do believe that this McGregor vs. Mayweather fight is going to be a success. I truly do believe it. Because, I mean, they have, what, 2 months to go for the fight. They have training, press tours, maybe, to do. And with Mayweather looking all out of shape and whatnot, you know, this is going to be... It'll play a downfall, most people will believe, including myself. However, I did hear rumors about Mayweather being in training about a month or two ago, all right, that he was training for this fight. So, likes that fake Tony Weeks so-called Twitter account, this picture or that video of Floyd Money Mayweather, you know, actually is a video. I've seen it on, what is it, Fight Hub. They were saying, you know, he's in shape and this and that. Well, however, you see Mayweather looking all flabby, you know, look like a 40-year-old man. But we'll see. But let's get down what I'm really here to see. One more thing. What I meant to say, that video could have been from earlier, okay? Could have been from, like, the wintertime or the fall, you know? But let's get what I'm trying to say here, get to the story. So, Deontay Wilder, all right? He wants to get paid to go overseas and fight. Or if he'll go overseas and fight, he's going to get paid. Here's the story. Deontay Wilder is willing to leave America for a major fight after linked with a WBC title defense in Britain, says promoter Lou DiBella. The American dismissed an offer to defend his WBC heavyweight belt against Dillian White this week, but the bronze bomber has also been targeted by Tony Bellew. WBC champion Deontay Wilder, 38-0, 37 KOs, damn what a record, is ready to travel overseas for the right deal. According to promoter Lou DiBella, who works closely with the fighter and his advisor Al Heyman, Wilder has received a great offer from British promoter Eddie Hearn, who wants the unbeaten champion to come over to the UK to make a title defense against Dillian White. But Wilder is not being very receptive to the terms of the deal despite the money involved. Hearn believes the bout with White will generate further interest in a high-stakes unification with IBF, WBA, IBO heavyweight champion Anthony Joshua, 19-0, 19 KOs. Wow, that's almost better than Deontay's record, who Hearn also promotes. Joshua is returning in the fall, either in a rematch with Vladimir Klitschko or an IBF mandatory defense against Kubrat Hulev. Wilder is also slated to return in the fall, but most insiders do not expect him to face mandatory challenger Bermain Stiverne in a rematch. If the money and the terms are right, DiBella says there is no problem with Wilder getting on a plane to travel for a major fight or for the right opportunity. Deontay has no hesitation to travel, as he proved when he was on his way to Russia to fight Alex Povetkin last year. I remember that, said DiBella to Sky Sports. All right, we are willing to travel for a big enough event. We will come over if the economic situation and the deal made sense. There is not going to be a hesitation to take the biggest fights. He is not going to be scared off by leaving the country. He has never been scared off by it. All right, so. Sounds pretty good. Deontay Wilder, hey, you want me to go, you gotta pay, all right? And I'm not mad at the dude. Now, I understand that the British pound is more than the American dollar. However, you must remember the currency rate exchange, all right? So, if he was paid, like, I guess, $6 million, I guess it'd be only worth, like, American money, probably, like, $7 million or so. It depends on the currency exchange rate, all right? So, I mean, it's not like always you're going to go over there and get this UK pounds and come back here and it'll be worth greater, you know, 4 or 5 times greater. So sometimes it doesn't matter. I mean, like I said, it depends on the currency exchange rate. So, but man, I would love to see Deontay Wilder against Anthony Joshua. But if he's not going to fight Bermain Stiverne, hate to say this, forget about Tony Bellew, man. That'll make him look like a cherry picker. go head on and take on Luis Ortiz. Get him out the way. Show the people you ain't scared. Just like you wasn't scared to fight Alex Parvaktigin over in his home country. You can stay here and take on Luis Ortiz, who happens to be one of the biggest threats in the heavyweight division. Well, that's my take on this. It's Ronell Higbox Reports. I'll see you on the next one.